Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. Today I will talk about COVID-19 in children. Coronavirus in children. Why children are less in number, infected less in number than the adults? And if they are infected with COVID-19, they have also the mild symptoms as compared to the adults in old age. Even though children are more vulnerable to the viral diseases, but if nowadays they have a lot of research on it, if children are infected with COVID-19, they might have more dangerous effect than is compared to the adults. So we will discuss all about COVID-19 coronavirus in children, but still there are a lot of gaps to be filled and a lot of research is going on about COVID-19, mostly in children. So COVID-19 is caused by a novel coronavirus, SARS-CoV-2. This first reported case were in the Wuhan district of China and appeared to be potentially from a zoonotic spillover at Huanan Seafood Wholesale Market. So it means first it was came from the animals to the human, and first reported case in China, but they are saying it is a seafood wholesale market. Subsequent cases were from person to person contact transmission, and suddenly it became epidemic and then pandemic. The virus is extremely contagious, particularly where there is a close contact between people. That's why they are saying distancing is important. And one person infects around three people. This is the old theory, but latest one is not this. This was that one person is usually it infects around three people. What is the pathophysiology of COVID-19, SARS-CoV-2? The virus appears to directly infect cells via ACE2 receptors, angiotensin converting enzyme 2. So this is the entry point of the virus. So this ACE2 enzyme, which is usually present in the lungs and also the heart and intestine, kidney, arteries. What happened, this enzyme is more in number in a patient who are old age and diabetes and hypertensive, and less in number in children. This is the one reason that children are less in number as compared to the adult and old age. But if this ACE2, it is less in number in the lungs in children. So what happened, this virus doesn't break down in the lungs. Usually it infect the heart, arteries and other organs because of this is also the drawback in children. So that's why it can affect the vital organs like heart of children more than the adults in old age. So this expressed in various organs including the lungs. So cells in children lung express this receptor less than those in adult lungs. So extrapulmonary involvement and multi-organ failure have been identified in a people with severe or fatal illness. So this is the pathophysiology of COVID-19. Usually it is a entry point has a ACE2, angiotensin converting enzyme 2. And this is an enzyme attached to the cell membrane of cells in the lungs, arteries, heart, kidney and intestine. So this they have one study which is there is a lack of this ACE2 in mice and is associated with severe injury to the heart, lung and other tissues. And this is the one reason that children are infected with this SARS-CoV-2, and if they are infected with this SARS-CoV-2, their heart is more vulnerable to be affected. So they found there is some similarity of signs and symptoms with Kawasaki disease and toxic shock syndrome. So you must know signs and symptoms of Kawasaki disease and toxic shock syndrome. But they found to know there is a multi-system inflammatory syndrome in children whenever there is no cause. So that's why they are saying multi-system inflammatory syndrome in children, which is MC, because of SARS-CoV-2. So this is associated with SARS-CoV-2, led to serious and life-threatening illness in previously healthy children and adolescents. So this is the thing, that if previously healthy child, they found the healthy children who are developing some sign and symptoms of inflammation without any reason, then they come to know that it could be because of SARS-CoV-2, and they named it multi-system inflammatory syndrome in children, MIS-C. So usually they present with persistent fever, fatigue, variety of signs and symptoms including multi-organ involvement and elevated inflammatory markers. So not all children have same sign and symptoms. The one reason, even not all individual, all even adult patients having, they don't have the same sign and symptoms. So this is also studies shows that it could be because of ACE2. Some people have a lack in number and some people are having a high in number. So this is also one reason. But still, there is no particular answer of these questions. So MIS-C, multi-system inflammatory syndrome in children, may present weeks after a child is infected with SARS-CoV-2. So there is a case definition of MIS-C by the CDC. What is CDC? CDC actually, this is CDC is a central disease control of usually in every country, but it initially basic CDC, when we are saying CDC because of COVID-19 CDC, we talk about the CDC of US. So they have a lot of research is going on. So many guidelines, many countries, they are following guidelines of the CDC, but still every country has their own guidelines regarding the management and also regarding the other sign and symptoms and other case definitions. But usually many countries they follow the CDC guidelines. So case definition: aged less than 21 years with fever and laboratory evidence of inflammation. So in the next slide we will talk about the fever and laboratory evidence of inflammation, what are the inflammatory markers we should go for, and also they have the multi-system organ involvement, which is more than two. It could be the lung and heart, it could be the skin and the heart, it could be intestine. Usually 80% of GIT is involved in children in one study. So there is no alternated possible diagnosis, and positive SARS-CoV-2 by RT-PCR, by the PCR, or exposure to a suspected or confirmed COVID-19 case within 4 weeks prior to the onset of symptoms. So this is the case definition of a multi-system inflammatory syndrome in children, MIS-C. So usually they affect, the mean age is 8.5 years. But they are saying 0 to 19 years, but the case definition is less than 21 years. So what about the fever and inflammatory markers? Fever, if it is more than 38 degrees Celsius for 24 hours, or report of subjective fever lasting more than 24 hours, including one or more of the following. So elevated C-reactive protein, ESR, erythrocyte sedimentation rate, fibrinogen, prolactin, D-dimer. D-dimer is an important, because increasing D-dimer is strongly suggestive of a death. So ferritin, lactic acid dehydrogenase, LDH, and interleukin 6, IL-6, elevated neutrophils, reduced lymphocytes, and low albumin. So these are the inflammatory markers which we should go for every patient who presented with signs or sign and symptoms of a multi-system inflammatory syndrome in children, MIS-C. So what are the presenting signs and symptoms? The constitution of fever, subjective fever or chills, cardiovascular like chest pain, tachycardia, hypotension, usually many cases they presented with a shock of cardiogenic shock, and in a previously healthy children, then they came to know this is because of a multicerebral inflammatory syndrome in children, we see because secondary to COVID-19. So gastrointestinal, which are abdominal pain, nausea, vomiting and or diarrhea. Dermatologic like rash, swelling of fingers, hands, toes or feet. Mucocutaneous conjunctival injection or mucosal changes, that's why there are similarities with Kawasaki disease and also toxic shock syndrome. Neurologic headache, altered mental status or confusion. Musculoskeletal myalgias or arthralgias, upper and lower respiratory tract infection like sore throat, congested throat, cough, difficulty of breathing or wheezing, and also they might have a lymphadenopathy. So still it is unclear which is the pathognomonic. There is no pathognomonic, so that's why they have a case definition which is still not clear. So differential diagnosis are a Kawasaki disease and toxic shock syndrome. So we will talk about little bit about Kawasaki disease and toxic shock syndrome signs and symptoms. So as we know, Kawasaki disease fever more than 5 days and four of the following like conjunctivitis, oral changes like red lips, pharynx, tongue, we call it also strawberry tongue, peripheral edema and rash, which are polymorphal rash, means no vesicle or crust. Lymph nodes, cervical usually more than 1.5 cm and presence of coronary artery aneurysm with any one of the following. So if there is coronary artery aneurysm and any one of the above, it means it is a Kawasaki disease, because this is the complication of a Kawasaki disease and even in a multisystem inflammatory syndrome in children. So toxic shock syndrome, usually they present with high grade fever and diffuse erythematous macular rash, and they have there is involvement of a conjunctiva, oral mucosa and also gelatin mucosa, vomiting and the diarrhea, altered consciousness. So these are the presenting sign and symptoms in a patient with Kawasaki disease and toxic shock syndrome in countries, developed countries like US and UK. They said if any patient who presented with these sign and symptoms, you should work out for a multisystem inflammatory syndrome in children and just report that case. It could be because of SARS-CoV-2. So those cases may have a hypercoagulability and COVID-19. So laboratory abnormalities and thrombotic complications. So laboratory abnormalities because of hypercoagulability are mild thrombocytopenia. Increased D-dimer level, which is strongly associated with greater risk of death. Increased fibrin degradation products, increased prothrombin time. And thrombotic complications are microvascular thrombosis of the toes, clotting of catheters, myocardial injury with ST segment elevation. Usually any patient who presented with signs and symptoms of multisystem inflammatory syndrome in children, we should go for the ECG, echocardiography, cardiac enzymes like troponin T, BNP. So these all are elevated with ST elevation, and also in echocardiography it would be the clear about the heart. So a large vessel stroke also, sometimes they have altered consciousness, so that's why they might have a stroke. So how to manage these cases, and still there is no particular medicine as we know. So management is varies from case to case, because mild cases can be managed at home of SARS-CoV-2, but the patient who is having multisystem inflammatory syndrome in children, so these if they are hospitalized, it means they are very severe cases. Usually sometimes they have the ICU admission. Also in some children they went for ECMO, which is extracorporeal membrane oxygenation. But cases who are hospitalized with heart involvement and other organ involvement, they usually give intravenous immunoglobulin IVIG, systemic glucocorticoids, and also if there is hypotension involvement, then they will give a supportive treatment of vasopressor. So this is little bit about multisystem inflammatory syndrome in children. And usually any patient who, any child who presents with these sign and symptoms like hyperinflammatory sign and symptoms like Kawasaki disease, toxic shock syndrome, and like we discussed about sign and symptoms of multisystem inflammatory syndrome in children and previously healthy child. So these should be ruled out about the SARS-CoV-2 multisystem inflammatory syndrome in children, but we should look for other diagnosis as well. And if there is no other diagnosis, there is no any criteria met with other diagnosis, then we should treat this child as a multisystem inflammatory syndrome in children. So in some countries they report this these cases, but in some countries still there is no particular guideline, but definitely they are working on it. And future, if they have these cases, it should be a report. And there is still a lot of studies is going on. Maybe tomorrow or near future, many guidelines would be changed, and they are working on it about multisystem inflammatory syndrome in children. Thank you very much.